if I had to recommend one film about Queen Elizabeth I, I'm pretty confident that that film would be the 1998 film Elizabeth, with Cate Blanchett as Elizabeth I. I love this film. 7.4 out of 10 on IMDb. Obviously a very well-liked film across the board. I think it's really exquisitely beautiful. Directed by Shekhar Kapoor and written by Michael Hirst. Starring, of course, Cate Blanchett as Elizabeth. And Kathy Burke is in this, is Queen Mary Tudor, which I love. It's got a pretty great cast all round. I think everybody kind of fits their roles nicely. And this begins with her ascension to the throne and then the early years of her being in power. And a lot of this focuses on the Queen's Council trying to find her a suitor. The Catholic attitudes towards the monarchy at the time, and also Lord Dudley. And there is obviously the film that comes after this that kind of goes into the years after, but certainly for me the more interesting time is when she's becoming queen, getting used to being in power and being this strong female figure where attitudes are very mixed. If I had to pick a time in history, say that's pre-19th century, I'd say the Tudors are the ones I know the most about. But that doesn't mean that I am the most knowledgeable. But from my perspective and from my understanding, this is pretty historically accurate. I'm sure some liberties have been taken, not to the extent of that new Anne Boleyn show that's on TV. But for the most part, I feel like I'm transported back in time. I feel like the representation is accurate enough. The costumes look amazing. They're a lot more realistic than a lot of similar crime films, historical films or historical dramas. Alexandra Byrne did the costumes. She's done some really phenomenal film costumes, you know, a lot of Jane Austen adaptations, Guardians of the Galaxy, Doctor Strange. You can kind of expect the fabulous, because that is what we're getting here, and it's a lot more realistic. I love that she's in the whites, but also in the saffrons. Her hair is a lot more realistic than these perfect pin-up things that a lot of Queen Elizabeth representations have. The narrative is presented very well. I feel like there's enough tension, but there are also times when we just feel it's a lot. There are times when it's quite gentle, and you just feel like you're inside her head, inside Liz One's head, and you can kind of take in the court and spend time absorbing the surroundings. And then, of course, the action picks up again, and things become quite intense, and it's certainly building up to Elizabeth the Golden Age, which I have to say is an absolutely phenomenal film. And you know, it's the same cast and crew behind that pretty much. So if you have already seen this film and you haven't seen The Golden Age, definitely watch it, because it's fantastic. But this one I think is my favourite of the two. I can't really fault it. As I said, 7.4 out of 10 on IMDb. It's very well received across the board. If I were to recommend any film about Elizabeth I, this would be it. I think it's pretty brilliant.